everyone. You have made it. It is the end of term two, and haven't you done an absolutely amazing job with remote learning, with at school? Wow, you've smashed it. So well done. And to celebrate, we've got three grade three girls who are going to take us out for our last Birkel Bargains for term two. Look out though, because next term we've got a list full of kids ready to go. So welcome to
Miss Birkel's Bargains!
Girls, you've got 30 seconds, and what I want you to do is pop these items in order from least expensive this end all the way to most expensive. So when you're ready, good luck.
Let's go move this here. Then go
up this up.
And you want maybe move that. No, that would be the second, and that would be the most. And
no, that wait, yes, that's
expensive. I'll go that. No, wait, that's new, so that might be a bit expensive.
No, I think that would be like here.
That would be the least.
I'll be
that
there.
I think. Wait, don't we want this here or like this?
Move these two, don't we?
Do we want to move these two?
Yes, just move those two.
Don't move those two. Alright.
I'm going to go like that.
Five. Four.
Yeah, move
three,
that one there.
Two. Okay. Oh-ho! I don't actually know how you've gone yet, so let's have a look. Girls, you didn't get 6 out of 6 this time round, unfortunately. You actually got a little bit like these Krispy Kreme donuts, a 0 out of 6 in the right spot. But you know what? You gave it a go and you've done great. So thank you. Help me though. I now need you to be magical with me and let's get them in the right spot for everyone at home. So Ella, thanks girls, well done. So have a look at home, see if you got 6 out of 6 this time round. Or knock the things off the table. But girls, for now, what should we say to everyone? Enjoy your holidays, have a great time, and
bye!
Oh, me name is Bob the Swagman, and before you all I stand. And I've had many ups and downs while travelling through the land. I once was well-to-do, me boys, but now I'm all stumped up. And I'm forced to go on rations in an old bark hut. In an old bark hut, in an old bark hut. Yes, I'm forced to go on rations in an old bark hut. 10 pounds of flour, 10 pounds of beef, some sugar and some tea. That's all they'll give a hungry man until the seventh day. If you don't be mighty sparing, you'll go with a hungry gut. For that's one of the great misfortunes in an old bark hut. In an old bark hut, in an old bark hut. That's one of the great misfortunes in an old bark hut. The bucket you wash your feet in is to boil your beef in two. They'd say you're getting mighty flash if you should ask for two. Of a billy and a pint pot and a broken handled cup. And they all adorn the table in the old bark hut. In the old bark hut, in the old bark hut. Yes, they all adorn the table in the old bark hut. The table is not made of wood, as many you have seen. For if it was half as good, I'd think myself serene. It's only an old dry sheet of bark, God knows when it was cut. It was blown down off the rafters of the old bark hut. In the old bark hut, in the old bark hut. It was blown down off the rafters of the old bark hut. Now furniture, there's no such thing, 'twas never in the place. Except the stool I sit upon, and that's an old gin case. It does me for a safe as well, but you must keep it shut. Or the flies would make it canter round the old bark hut. Round the old bark hut, round the old bark hut. Yes, the flies would make it canter round the old bark hut. If you should leave it open and the flies should find your meat, They'll scarcely leave a single piece that's fit for man to eat. You mustn't curse or grumble what won't fatten will fill up. What's out of sight is out of mind in the old bark hut. In the old bark hut, in the old bark hut. What's out of sight is out of mind in the old bark hut. In summer when the weather's warm, this hut is nice and cool, and you'll find the breezes blowing in through every hole. You can leave the old door open, or you can leave it shut. There's no fear of suffocation in the old bark hut. In the old bark hut, in the old bark hut. There's no fear of suffocation in the old bark hut. In the winter time, preserve us all to live in, it's a treat. Especially when it's raining hard and blowing wind and sleet. The rain comes down the chimney, your meat is black with soot. That's a substitute for pepper in the old bark hut. In the old bark hut, in the old bark hut. That's a substitute for pepper in the old bark hut.
I'm here to interview some grade fives about their Gold Rush presentations. So, who are you?
Well, I'm the Nungabum, an Aboriginal elder from the Dja Dja tribe. Well, me and my tribe fought in the Battle of the Eureka Stockade. Well, I stole sheep and then shedded them for wool to get money, because we were poor, so.
I am Charles James Roberts. I protected the Chinese miners. I was the mayor of New South Wales and also was a politician.
I'm Peter Layla. I fought in the Eureka Stockade. I was the leader of it. I was a member of the upper and lower house and an official gold miner.
I'm Alan Clacy and I'm like an author, so I would describe the landscape around me and everything. Well, she had five siblings, three were girls, two were boys.
I'm Frank Gardner.
My gang hosted Australia's largest robbery. We stole £14,000, including 77 kilograms of gold and 10 bags of cash, which now valued in Australian dollars is $12.5 million.
Wow. Okay.
I was a bushranger and I was the first ever person exiled out of Australia.
I'm George Lansell, a gold millionaire. I brought a gold mine for £30,000.
I have four sons and one daughter.
Caroline Chisholm. I helped people find jobs and homes when they came over from like England and stuff. I was also a woman activist.
I'm Agnes Buntine. I was the first female bullock in Australia delivering goods in a cart pulled by bulls. Back in Scotland where I was born, I was a dairymaid, and when I immigrated to Australia, I opened a small dairy farm with my husband Hugh, and we also opened a bush inn, and I went on to be a bullocky driver.
I'm Samuel Thomas Gill.
I was a goldfields artist.
Well, I was born on the 18th of March 1880. Well, in my years, I produced 24 lithographs.
So that was like
made out of stone and stuff.
I am Raffaello Carboni. And I'm a Eureka Stockade leader.
George Lansell. Well, I'm a gold mine owner and a gold miner. I owned a butcher shop and a soap and candle business.
I am Ben Hall and I was a bushranger. So I was with Frank Gardiner in his gang and I also stole £12,000 with him.
Henrietta Dugdale. I'm a suffragette. It's a woman seeking the right to vote through organised protest.
I am Antonio Fortri. He is a photographer and journalist on the goldfields. He is from France and he sailed to Australia in 1852.
There are some amazing presentations here in Grade 5.
In this big, wide, golden country, surrounding old Kalgoorlie town, there's the old-time pomp and glory. You can be part of their story. In fortunes that were made,
fortunes that were lost and fortunes still to find. In gold rush country, nickel strike country, scene of the golden mile. Gold rush country, gold rush country, recall the name and stake your claim. In gold rush country, recall the name and stake your claim. Gold rush country, in gold rush country.
And now it's time for the birthdays.
And it's a happy birthday too.
On Monday, we have Elijah.
On Tuesday, we have Nicholas.
On Wednesday, we had Finn,
Miranda, and Isabella.
And on Friday, we have Emily
and Kayla.
And on Sunday, we have Henry
and Lola.
Happy birthday!
Seconds
to write down your answers
for the categories.
Time starts now. Good luck.
You'll need it.
Thank you.
For food, I got peach.
I got pine nut. I got potato.
I got pineapple.
For job, I got president.
I got photographer. I got peasant.
I got painter.
For a girl's name, I got Phoebe, me.
I got Pippa, me. I got Penny, not me.
I got Prue.
For country, I got Peru.
I got Philippines.
I also got Philippines.
And I also got Philippines.
For animal, I got pufferfish.
I got puppy.
I got Pegasus.
And I got penguin.
For dog breed, I got poodle.
I got papilla.
I got Pomeranian.
And I got pug.
For boy's name, I got Patrick.
I got Philip.
I got Parker.
And I got Paul.
For colour, I got pink.
I got peach.
I got pumpkin orange.
And I got purple.
For a teacher's name, I got Miss Palmer.
I got Miss Palmer too.
So did I.
And I got Miss Palmer as well.
For a four-letter word, I got park.
I got park.
I got park.
I got park as well.
Thanks for watching. Bye. Wow.
Righto, g'day everybody. Very exciting time here this morning. We're celebrating our Sports Academy, Mr. Mac. We finally got it off the ground.
Yeah, I tell you what, COVID couldn't stop us. We spent a lot of time getting all the background information onto this and why we do it and why we are an amazing school. And we got it off the ground, even though COVID tried to stop us.
So the Rosebud Primary, first ever Sports Academy. But it doesn't happen without the wonderful abundance of superstar coaches that we have. Let's go meet them.
Yes, let's go meet them.
Come on, our first one. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Robbie.
Robbie.
So what was your favourite part of After School Footy Academy, mate?
I was just watching the kids just getting right into it. It was really good to see. They love it. It's really good for them.
Yeah, and he also does a lot of lunchtime stuff. We have game day, 5-6 game day, 3-4 game day.
What's this?
And also, what is that, actually? What is that?
Believe it or not, we run a hockey program here too. And luckily enough for Rosebud Primary, we're actually taking a bunch of kids next term to learn how to play ice hockey.
What? Oh, there's an exclusive ice hockey next term. Thanks, Robbie, for all you do.
It's coming. Next one. Here we go. Our basketball stars over here in the corner. Mr. Bond and Keithy, tell us a little bit about it.
Well, we've been doing hoop time Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, lunchtime. So we've got the grade 3s, 4s, 5s and 6s, which has been awesome.
And am I right in saying hoop time's next term, early next term, for about 170 kids in the program?
Yeah, I think we got week 2 next term, so a big week 2 next term, but looking forward to going to Dandenong, I think we are, and playing against all the other teams.
Well, these guys have just finished running, Mr. Mac.
They're puffed, they're stretching. Have a look at this.
I can see Ms. Boyd's just keeping things loose. Ms. Boyd, you're involved in the before school cross country team training this term. How did you find that? Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was great. What a way to start the day. You know, a nice run over. Beautiful.
Yeah, and the cross-country team loved it, and it helped us get even better results in those mornings. There were some fresh ones, wasn't there, Miss Boyd? Absolutely.
But we had about 50, I think, Miss Boyd, was one morning, which is massive. So yeah, an awesome turnout. Well done. Oh. Now, this sport is about to blow up at our school. I'm telling you, Mr. Mac.
It is.
We've got two absolute gurus leading the charge, Miss McDermott, Miss White. What's been your favourite part of it? Netball Sports Academy this term?
I'd like to see the improvement on the girls. We trained all term after school on Thursday. Actually, some boys as well, girls and boys, and they just improved so much. We were just chatting about the improvement in stepping. Yes.
Wow.
Fantastic.
And Miss White, are we training towards anything? All this training and time and effort we're putting in, are we working towards something?
Yes, we are. Well, first of all, we're going to take over basketball and footy. Ooh. Take over the world. No, we are training really hard for the Vic Schools Championships coming up in week 5, term 3. So that's for all of our 5s and 6 girls. So girls, if you would like to be involved in that, we are sending off 3 teams. So come along to training Thursday afternoons and every recess next term.
Oh, what do we have over here?
We've got a bit of weight training going on.
Fitness gurus, our prep fitness gurus, prep fitness fanatics, Miss Clough, Miss D, tell us all.
Yeah, so we've been doing Friday morning prep fitness fanatics, and we get an excellent turnout under the big shedder in the hall, and it's lots of fun, a great way to start our Friday.
Mr. Houston, known as Rog.
Have a look at Roger.
Look at the back end here. Just doesn't miss a beat. And there's no way this is blowing up at our school as well. Junior tennis, this has been going, this is nearly your third year with this, Mr. Houston, you're at the Tennis Academy, I think.
Yeah, it is my third year actually running it on mornings before school. So far so good. It's building up. We're getting a lot of kids come along. I think it's about 30 kids, a lot come from before school care to come across and be part of it. So yeah, a lot of kids are interested at the moment.
Lucky last, we've got our sports captains, guys. And I think they wanted to jump in and say something. We've got Chase, Lex, who are doing a wonderful job this year.
Huge thank you to all the teachers that run the Sports Academy.
Without the teachers, we couldn't run the Sports Academy, so thank you, teachers.
Awesome. Mr. Mack, like I said, it's finally off the ground. We're ready to roll. And hey, there's a big stadium not too far around the corner that's going to help things out as well.
Yep, the Palace is on its way. So Sports Academy, onward and upward at Rosebud Primary School. Get involved.
Welcome back to My Darts Footy Tippers.
How you going, Lexi?
Good, how are you?
Who have you got with you this week?
I have Foster, Parker and Oscar.
You guys want to wave to the camera for us? Say g'day, everyone.
G'day.
Oh, good on you, boys. Now, you've lived up to your promise. I wasn't sure if you're going to. You've lived up to promise. We've got boys from Prep D, is that right?
Yep.
Nice one. So they're here to help you do some tipping this week?
Yes.
Before we get started, Foster, yeah. Who do you barrack for?
Collingwood.
Oh, Mr.
Mack. Oscar, what about you? You're twins and you go for different teams. Yeah, Sydney and Saints.
Let me guess. Mum and Dad barracked for Sydney and St Kilda as well. Well done, keeping the family nice and symmetrical, I like it. And you must be best friends with Mr. Mack and Miss Burkle, are you? Big Collingwood fans together, eh?
And Mr. T.
Wow, there's plenty of Collingwood people around. They're everywhere.
Oh, it's horrible.
And was he wearing Collingwood gear or was he wearing Rosebud footy gear? Or just his normal school clothes? Oh, just normal clothes. Yeah. He loves footy, doesn't he? Loves footy, Mr. Mack. Hey, what do you guys reckon? We get into the first game of tipping?
Yep.
All right. Now, the first game is Brisbane versus Geelong. Can someone tell me who they think is going to win?
Oscar.
Where's Oscar? Who is going to win, Brisbane or Geelong, Oscar?
Brisbane.
Brisbane's going to win? You know what? I've actually had a bit of a sneak peek of the tips this week, and I'm going to change my tip. I was going to say Brisbane too, but I'm going to be different, and I think Geelong are going to win.
Because our tips were going to be all the same.
Pretty similar. So you know what? I'm going to go Geelong because I want to increase my lead.
Richmond, and I don't know what's the next game.
Richmond and St Kilda is the next game. Who's going to tip that one?
Parker.
Do you remember who you tip? Oh, good one. I'm not going to change my tip on that one. I think Richmond are going to be too good for St Kilda. Sorry, Mr. Fisher. The third game, this must be yours, is it, Foster?
Yep.
It's Collingwood versus Fremantle.
No, it's not. It's Melbourne, isn't it?
Running sheet says Collingwood versus Fremantle, okay. Lexi. Anyway, we'll go Collingwood Fremantle. Who's going to win?
Collingwood.
I didn't really need to ask you that, did I? You were just going to say Collingwood regardless. Mm-hmm. Yeah, good on you. I think Collingwood too. Collingwood will win that one. Now, the next game, this is the one you were thinking of, Lexi, is North Melbourne versus the Gold Coast. Who's tipping this one for you, Lex?
Me.
You're tipping it. Who are you going to go? Sorry, Lexi, what was that? Nice and loud so the microphone can hear it.
North Melbourne.
Oh, I think we need to say it one more time. Boys, you want to help us say it nice and loud for me? 1, 2, 3.
North Melbourne.
Yes, we're all going North Melbourne this week. North Melbourne's going to beat Gold Coast. That should be a good game too.
Yes.
The next game is Port Adelaide versus Sydney. Who's tipping this one?
No, it's Oscar.
Oscar, you're tipping this one. Okay, who's going to win?
Sydney.
Now you're the one who barracks for Sydney, aren't you?
No.
Oh, sorry, Parker. You barrack for Sydney. Well, good decision, Barrett, on tipping your brother's team.
And he didn't go against your brother's team, did you? He said the other opposite team.
St Kilda, what was it?
Oh, I think he went for Richmond on that one.
Yeah.
But
that's okay.
Can't blame him for that. That's a pretty good decision. Our next game is Essendon versus Melbourne.
We've gone Melbourne.
Oh, were you tipping this one, Lex?
Yes.
Oh, good one. Okay. So you guys are tipping Melbourne. Oh, did I tip the last one? I don't think I said. But I'm going to tip Port Adelaide for that Sydney and Port Adelaide game. And this one, I'm going to tip Melbourne.
Yeah.
So I think that's the same, isn't it? You guys tip Melbourne then too,
yes,
didn't you?
Cool.
Hey, do you want to read out these teams for me?
Hawks and the Suns.
Or Hawks and the Giants.
Hawks and the Giants.
And I didn't get to, when we were tipping, I didn't even get to say something. And what did you boys pick?
Didn't you?
They said Hawthorn.
That's good coaching, Lexi. It went through seamlessly. I'm sure they all tipped Hawthorn unanimously. No one was pushed into anything they didn't want to do.
Yeah, no one was.
Nah, I did see that. And all the boys were quite adamant that Hawthorn were going to win, weren't you, boys? Yep. I disagree. GWS will win. We'll get through these last couple of games pretty quick. West Coast and Bulldogs. Who's going to win that one? Parker? Good boy, West Coast. I think West Coast will win as well over there. They're pretty hard to beat at home ground. And our last game for the round is Carlton and Adelaide. Who's tipping this one?
Me.
Go on, Foster.
Carlton.
Carlton. You reckon Carlton are going to win?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, good. But you got to say it like Carlton. Can you say that for me?
Carlton.
Yeah, good boy.
No, it's Carlton.
I agree. I think Carlton will get the win on that one. Hey, boys, did you have fun footy tipping this week?
Mm-hmm. Next one is, what was it? Prep B or Prep A? It'll be a mystery.
Mystery week. I like it, Lex. All right. Thank you, boys. We're going to wave to the camera and say see you later, everyone.
Bye. Bonjour.
Hello everybody, I'm here with Miss Burkle. We're excited, Miss Burkle, next term. Something big is coming.
It is. Mr. Smith, it came to me with the most amazing idea, and that is to link our school up with...
Olympics.
The Olympics. When is it happening, Mr. Smith?
Well, week two, it's all going down. Miss Burkle, she's the guru of what goes on, leads the charge in our classrooms with maths and English.
So we have linked the entire week to have something to do with Olympics in maths and in English. Everything you learn will have the theme of Olympics, so it's going to be heaps and heaps of fun. Mr. Smith, and how are we going to celebrate it at the end of the week?
Well, at the end of that week of week two, and it's a bit of a coincidence, that the actual opening ceremony is on the Friday night, so we're going to have an Olympic day on that Friday at school.
Timing, Mr. Smith.
To celebrate all of the wonderful work that's going on in the classroom that week. But even more excitingly, I know the teachers, every grade's going to get a country that they're going to come and celebrate and dress up as that day. The teachers, it's very serious business on what country they get.
There's a few teachers putting a bit of pressure on us at the moment, isn't there, Mr. Smith? And I want this country, I want this.
There's a very, very healthy Olympic competition going on between the teachers. So what we're going to do, the teachers have just picked all their countries. We've just let the document go live.
Where's the thing? Miss D, where's the country sheet?
I don't know, have a look, it's there.
We're gonna tell you what country is allocated to what grade. To start off with, drum roll, 6C.
6C.
Miss D, has that list gone live yet?
Yep.
Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it?
It's in there.
If I miss out on Mexico. What do you mean I've missed out on Mexico?
your birth.
The letter's D.
No, it's not you. It's Tyson.
Welcome back to Rosebud Primary.
What is that?
Mardi da. What? Now let's head over to Mr. Mac for Mr. Mike's Mac.
You're doing good. Yourself perform. Yourself. Oh my God. It's like
God and performance.
My name's Olivia. Welcome to Brain Busters.
No! No, that's not it.
I wonder what the letter is today. Let's spin the wheel.
The letter is B!
Stop!
You have 1 minute and 40 seconds to write down your answers.
With Nathan Buckley retiring from Collingwood Nathan Buckley retiring as Blues. Who was it? Was it Melbourne and Collingwood? Yeah.
What a spectacular array of student work we have been.
What a spectacular array of student work presented to us today.
Not today. Not this morning. This week.
What a spectacular array of student work presented to us this week.
Enjoy your long weekend, because don't come to school on Monday because it's the... Wait, no, what was I going to say?
So it's good. Music camp from Monday to Friday has been postponed till a later date.
Wednesday to Friday, mate. The Queen's birthday, so don't come to school.
Not on Wednesday.
On Monday? Wait, no?
During lockdown, Mr. Fisher organised a Lego...
Off you go, Len. What do we need to say to them?
I'm not sure.
Oh, you're going
to
do...
Welcome back to Brain Busters!
So at Rosebud, our sustainable practice is imprinted in everything we do. Embedded... I'll start again. Come up and so if you're looking for some plants, and want to start that again.
But first, we'd like to. The Mighty Ducks.
What?
The screw poles have been put. Have I said been twice?
You know the rules.
You have 1 minute and 40 seconds. 1 minute and 45 seconds
to write down your answer.
40.
40!
Sorry! Who have dressed up and done their presentations. Can we restart that? We are here in the grade 5 portables to... In the grade 5... About their gold rush presentations. So...
We also opened a bush inn and I went on to be a bullocky driver. And that is all. Good day.
Classrooms are going to have math... Hello, everybody.
Hi everyone, I hope you've had an awesome term. It's been action-packed. We've had a bit of COVID in there, but we've bounced back and everything like that. I hope you all have a wonderful break. Next term when you come back, there's a lot going on right from the outset. So have a break, enjoy time with your family, get away.
Stay safe everyone, have a fabulous break. And again, thank you so much for everything you've done this term. We couldn't be prouder of you. See you later.